It is officially fall! Even though technically I've been in full-on spooky mode for weeks now, but whatever. Today I'm gonna be sharing with you my October TBR, which includes two readathons. One, which I'm actually hosting, that is the Scaredy Cat Readathon. I'm so excited. It's gonna be the whole month of October. And then I'm also participating in another readathon. I'm sure you may have heard of it. It is the Sweater Weather Readathon hosted by Abigail, Liv, and Zoe. That is like the last full week of October. So I'm just gonna like go through everything that I wanna read for those. And we're gonna start with, of course, the Scaredy Cat Readathon. I'm biased. This is actually the first readathon I have ever hosted. So to mark this momentous occasion, I'm going to be attempting to do something else which I have never done before, and that is, I'm going to try to black out the board. So the way this readathon is set up, if you haven't seen my announcement video, go check it out. But basically it is a choose your own adventure sort of thing. So you have three different paths that you can take that all lead you to a different spooky location. So technically I am like the admin for the graveyard path, which is the one that goes down the middle of the map. But I'm gonna try to do all three. So starting with the pumpkin patch path, the first prompt for that is sweet treat, which is to read a book with a romance as sweet as candy. So I have a few different ones for this. I'm gonna try to do an audiobook for this one. So I have a few different options, but the one I am most excited about and will probably try to do is XOXO by Axie O. This is one of my most highly anticipated books of 2021. And literally, like, it's a K-pop romance. I mean, this is basically every ARMY's dream, you guys. So it will probably be playing out in my head like a Jimin fanfic. Okay, next we have the Happily Ever After prompt, which is to read a book that is either a fairy tale retelling or just has like really strong fairy tale vibes. So for this one, I'm gonna be reading our group book, which is The School for Good and Evil by Saman Chainani. I'm really, really excited about this one because I literally have not read a middle grade, I want to say like since the beginning of this year, back when I read Magnus Chase. And I've really been wanting to get back into like the magical middle grade genre, so I think this is going to be perfect. Plus the map in the beginning of this book is so cute, like it's giving me very strong Hogwarts vibes. Okay, next up we have My Pathway, and the first prompt for that one is the Poe prompt, which is in honor of Edgar Allan Poe, and that is to read a book starting with a P, an O, or an E. I struggled with this one so much. Like literally I went through my entire Goodreads TBR of like 100+ books. I only found like two and I wasn't really in the mood for either of them. And then literally last night I realized that the audiobook I'm currently listening to starts with an E. And that is An Enchantment of Ravens by Margaret Rogerson. And then the second prompt for that path is Creepy Crawlies, which is to read a book with bugs in it. So I'm going to be reading Carrie and the Night of the Forest by Andy Watson. Okay, and then for the Haunted Mansion pathway, technically the Poe prompt is also for that path. It kind of like diverges between the two different locations. But after that, the next prompt is like, I think it's called Eat Your Brains. I should know. That is to read a book with a brainy main character, because zombies eat brains. So so for that one, I'm going to be reading the next volume in Witch Hat Atelier, and that is by Kamami Shirahama. Coco is literally the sweetest. Ugh, I love her. She's so cute. And this whole story is basically like a gender swapped Harry Potter. It's not actually, but like, it's definitely very strong Harry Potter vibes, and Coco is just super smart and super brave and just curious about everything. Like literally every time she learns something new, she has like a little mini freak out, and it is like, that is totally how I was as a little kid. I just loved to learn, and I see so much of myself in her, so I'm really excited to continue with this series. The next prompt is the Haunted Mansion prompt. So that is to read a book set in a haunted location. So for this prompt, I'm going to be reading Vampires, Hearts, and Other Dead Things by Margie Fustin. I'm assuming that this will fit for this prompt. I mean, literally the cover has them both like hanging out in a graveyard, so I'm gonna say that counts. Okay, and then we also have two shortcut prompts on the map. So that is for like if you wanna visit all three of the locations, but you don't really have time to go through every single prompt. So the first one is actually to have a spooky movie night. Then between the graveyard and the haunted mansion, we have the Casper prompt, which is to read a book with a friendly ghost. So for this one, I'm going to be reading A Gift for a Ghost by Borja Gonzalez. Okay, so that is everything for the Scaredy Cat Readathon. Next up, we have the Sweater Weather Readathon. Next up, we have the Sweater Weather Readathon. I did try really hard to come up with separate books for each of the two readathons. Like, I may not end up doing all of that, and I may end up kind of doubling up between the two, but I'm at least going to make separate TBRs for them. However, I tried so hard, but I could not find a single book on my TBR that had orange on the cover, except for People We Meet on Vacation, which really is just more of a summary book. So I really didn't want to read that for like a cozy fall readathon. So I am going to also be using Vampires, Hearts, and Other Dead Things for this prompt as well, because if you look close, the dress that the girl is wearing is orange. So it counts. So then the next one is to read a book that takes place during fall. And for this one, I'm super excited. This is probably one of my most anticipated reads for the spooky season, and that is The Nature of Witches by Rachel Griffin. And I happen to know that Abigail, who's one of the hosts of this readathon, is also reading this. So I thought it would be kind of fun to like read it along with her. Then read a book in a format that you don't typically read in. So for me, that would be ebooks. I'm not the biggest fan of ebooks. However, I have recently found quite a few that I have some sort of free access to either through Amazon Prime or Kindle Unlimited. So I'm going to be reading a graphic novel, and that is Sui and the Shadow by Ginger Lee. Next up we have read a book with a fall word in the title. And for this one, I'm also going to be reading a graphic novel, which I got through NetGalley. It is my first official NetGalley read, and that is Artie and the Wolf Moon by Olivia Stevens. I have already started reading through this book, and it is so cool. Like, the color scheme is so good. It's basically exactly what the cover looks like. It's got lots of like moody blues and greens, but then with like pops of red in there, and it just makes it look so spooky and fun, so I'm really excited about this one. And then the last prompt for this readathon is to read a backlist title. So basically anything published before 2021. So I have a lot of options for this one, but I think my two top picks are either Cinder or Three Dark Crowns, because I have access to both of those through Scribd. So we'll see. I might also end up doubling up for this prompt as well, just because it's like so broad that pretty much half of the books from the Scaredy Cat Readathon could also work for this one. So we'll see. I'm trying to keep that one kind of open as kind of like a free space. So those are all 10 books that I am planning on reading this October. Like I said in my Scaredy Cat Readathon announcement video, totally fine to go ahead and start reading early. So even though technically this is my October TBR, I am giving myself a couple of extra weeks just to make sure that I give myself as much of a chance as possible of getting through all of these. Let me know down below what you're planning on reading for October, and are you planning on participating in these readathons as well? I would love it if you did, especially the Scaredy Cat readathon. As always, let me know if there's any way that I can be encouraging you or praying for you. Otherwise, I'll see you next time. Bye!